Hello, Mr. Arniger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I am describing the condition of the church that has become worse than those of the temple rabbi condition, and how these bishops and other people put on these silken clothing to impress upon the simple-minded people. So this Jesus described in Matthew 12:43-45, when an unclean spirit, the hypocrite temple priest and rabbis, goes out of a man, that the men used to go to the temple in the Jerusalem, the women were not allowed to speak, cry, Jesus set us free of their yoke, of the temple priest yoke, by giving his own sacrifice as the Lamb of God. He goes through the temple priest spirit, the evil spirit goes through dry places. Dry places mean can't find a victim or a prey seeking rest so he can establish himself, and finds none. So they find none, you know, to make their, they became useless, as Jesus said in the parable of the wine press. The husbandmen became useless as they were not producing good quality fruit. These temple priests used to being served by the simpletons could not find their victim, as most people hated them for killing the just men like Jesus, James, and Stephen. Then he says, I will return to my house from which I came. These Jews became bishops in churches and brought back the written Torah as a bait to catch those simpletons, and established themselves in the churches, especially of Judea region, where they expelled the third eye-opening apostles. So these Jewish people, Messianic Jews, they expelled the apostles first from the Judea region. The apostles used to rebuke them for bringing the rotten old Torah into the churches, and that is the Jewish leaven, and to keeping the people bogged down in the prayer and in other rituals. But the bishop retorted by saying to the apostles, do what I tell you to do, otherwise don't come. So they expelled them. So when these sycophant bishops got the Romans in their fold, then they killed the apostles by throwing them before the animals, burning them at stake, and burning their books, etc. Until recently, people like Martin Luther showed us freedom of expression. Now, you can well imagine how cruel the master they became, as predicted by Jesus. And when he, the temple priest, the Messianic Jews, comes, he finds it empty. That means they found the people hearts empty. There no one to go for. Swept and put in order. They were clean. They were very humble. More humble than those temple priests used to have. This Christ Jesus had done through his sacrifice and blood. Then he goes and takes with him seven other spirits. These seven are the seven deacons you find in churches, that you find in Orthodox and other established churches instead of fellowships in honor of Christ Jesus. They were more wicked than himself. That means they were more wicked than previous temple rabbis and temple priests. And they enter and dwell there. So they established themselves in this new place, which is the church, in the name of Jesus. So they sold the name of Jesus, put on yokes on people as the popes did. And the last state of that man, the present state of the simpletons that are easily caught in the web, is worse than the first. The first was the state before Christ Jesus came. They had to bear the yoke of one rabbi. Before they had to be only one rabbi, only. And now you have seven more deacons to bear their yoke. So shall it also be with this wicked generation of messianic Jews and their stooges. These Russian bishops and their stooges, they are no less, you know, than those messianic Jews. Can you find simpletons worse than these Russians and the bishops, more impressively dressed than these Russian police? That means these are people who are Russian or other bishops you find among them. You won't find anything better or more impressively dressed than these Russian bishops. They put on like whitewashed cups full of filth out inside. This is from Matthew 12:43-45. I was just wondering what Jesus would think of you. There's a priest in Reading who comes. He's a nice man, but he also is caught up in this web. He has put on this clothing and all that. So if Jesus happens to enter his church, you know, while he is performing the service in his dress, impressive silken dress. In Jesus, what comes out of your own mouth, that matters, and not what the books, the scriptures say. Scriptures could be corrupted, but the gospel cannot be corrupted because it is received through revelation. It is the time for gospel, and those who preach gospel are not dressed in silk and gold, but ordinary civilian dresses, who work for the living as Christ, Paul. You know, they called Paul a saint, but in fact he was a Christ who can preach gospel. So as Christ or Saint Paul did as a tent maker. He was a tent maker who was making his living out of that one. I'm not accusing any of you any wrongdoing in Jesus, but please just talk to your own heart. And that is what I do myself. I like your sermons and they make a lot of sense. Let us see what you think of my views. So I just send him this thing, that what he thinks of my views. Then the present situation was also described by Jesus in Matthew 24:27 onward. For as lightning that cometh from the east, the lightning will come from the east, but it won't flash there, is visible even to in the west. That means it will flash towards the west. It would be appreciated in the west, not in the east. In the east they want money, mammon loving. So will be the coming Son of Man. Coming Son of Man was Christ, Nanak Devji, which we call him Satguru. He came in 1469. He was the second coming of Christ Jesus. So many people don't know that he is the second coming of Christ Jesus, but in the next video I will explain it in detail. So please wake up and make progress in the name of Jesus.